Hello everybody and welcome back to the channel. Today I want to talk about the NHL's trophies, especially about what is the early pick for who will win which trophy for the 2021-2022 season. I already wrote down the trophy names on the board. We will talk about them all one after another. I will pick some players that could win the trophy and I will make a pick who will win which trophy. For now. Of course, this might change to the end of the regular season. I will come back and do another video where I make my final picks at the end of the regular season. But for now, who will, I think, win which trophy up to this point of the NHL season? So, let's get it on. So, let's start with the Rocket Richard trophy for the guy who scores the most goals in the regular season. Right now, the leader is Leon Draisaitl with 25 goals, followed by Alex Ovechkin with 24. Who will win the trophy at the end of the season in regard of now? I think at the end of the season, the trophy will go to Auston Matthews, who right now has 20 goals, so he's 5 behind Leon Draisaitl, but I think he will have a very good second half of the season, and Matthews should get the Rocket. Next up, the Art Ross. Right now the points leader is Connor McDavid with 53 points, followed by Leon Draisaitl with 52, and Alex Ovechkin with 50. And I think the end of the year, the Art Ross trophy will go to Connor McDavid. He is so skilled. He is the best player in the league. Right now, he and Draisaitl, they are both a little bit in a slump, and the Oilers are in a slump altogether. But I think they will come back and score a lot of points, and McDavid will end up number one. The Jack Adams Award is handed out to the coach of the year. So, I have four guys written down who could win this right now. Okay, one is not realistic. One would be Bruce Boudreau, who took over the Canucks after they fired Travis Green. And they have a very solid record under Boudreau, but he didn't coach them the whole season. So although he would be maybe points percentage-wise a candidate, but I think he's not. More candidates. Peter Laviolette, who took the Washington Capitals and kept them a contender. They are a contender. The Capitals playing fantastic hockey right now. Let's see if he wins it. Or maybe Dean Evason of the Minnesota Wild, who is also keeping the Wild at the top. And they are a contender, although they are in a little slump right now, but they'll find out of it. Minnesota is a contender. So is Dean Evason. One more candidate. Oh no, two more. Daryl Sutter of the Calgary Flames. The Flames were out of the playoffs last year. They were eliminated in the first round after winning the bubble play-in first round 2 years ago. The Flames looked like they are fantastic. They are so good on the road. The system works perfectly. Daryl Sutter is absolutely a candidate. But I think John Hines of the Nashville Predators. The Predators were considered to be bottom feeders. Maybe 6th, 7th in the division. I had them picked 7th, far out of the playoffs. They turned out to be, at the point at the day of recording, the leaders of the Central Division. They are first. Unbelievable. Great accomplishment, John Hines. Next up is the Hart. Looked like to be a tied race between Connor McDavid and Leon Draisaitl, although they play on the same team, so who's benefiting more from the other? But as the Oilers are in a slump right now, they might get out points-wise, but they will take votes away from each other. And I think the Hart Trophy this year will go for the first time to the guy who's deferring the aging process, who will, if he continues playing, in 3, maybe 4 years, be the all-time goal-scoring leader of the league. Alex Ovechkin. He has so many assists. Right now, Ovechkin has 34 games played, 24 goals, 26 assists, 50 points, plus 19. Fantastic season. Ovi, the great eight, is really great this year. If he can keep it up, the heart is his. The Calder Trophy is handed out to the Rookie of the Year. I have six names on my list. One is Dahlin from the San Jose Sharks, who is playing a fantastic season. Janot of the Nashville Predators. He is so good and he fits so good into the system. Unbelievable. Of course, then we have to go to Detroit. Alex Nedeljkovic, who I was so surprised Carolina didn't extend him and that he ended up in Detroit. He has showed this year why the Wings are paying him some money. Who else do we have? Lucas Raymond, also Detroit Red Wings. First year player, doing so good. Right now he's in a little goal scoring slump, but he will come out of that. And he will be a fantastic player who would deserve this award. Don't forget, Dawson Mercer, New Jersey Devils. Fits so good with Heischer, Hughes. Mercer is maybe a little step behind these two, but not much. He could be on the road to be first line center for the Devils. I think the trophy will go to... Moritz Seider. Not only because I saw him play live in the stadium several times. Okay, he was a little younger and he played for the Adler Mannheim in the DEL. He adapted to the NHL so good, playing after his draft was 2019. He played 1 year in the AHL, then he played 1 year in the SHL in Sweden for Rögle. He was fantastic there and he transformed seamlessly into the NHL. Will have a fantastic career. Will be a fantastic player, great defenseman and cornerstone at the blue line of the Wings. The Vezina is for me the second hardest to pick. So much good goaltending, so many great plays by the goaltenders this year. And let me count. I have seven candidates on the list. Of course, you always have to mention Andrei Vasilevsky, Tampa Bay Lightning. For me, the best goaltender in the league. Maybe not this year. I don't think he will win it. But Vasi is always on this list. Tristan Jarry, Pittsburgh Penguins. We all said the Penguins' weak spot is goaltending. I said so too. I was so wrong. Jarry and DeSmith elevated their game to the next level. Both fantastic. Jarry the better one of them. Frederik Andersson. Last year with Toronto, he was so far away from a Vezina list. This year in Carolina, he should be near the top. Fantastic saves, fantastic win record, fantastic save percentage. Andersson, just great. Jacob Markstrom, Calgary Flames. Most shutouts in the league right now. His resurgence helps the Flames so much. He is so good. Two more. Jack Campbell, Toronto Maple Leafs. What a season. Where would the Leafs be without Campbell? He's stolen a lot of games. He's so solid. It just works. Maybe Toronto finally solved their problems in net. We will see if this keeps up. He is on this list definitely. But I think this Vezina winner this year Shesterkin, New York Rangers, and I'm not wearing Rangers for no reason. Igor Shesterkin, fantastic. Is there anything to say? He could even be in the heart conversation. He is so good. Best goals against, average, one of the best save percentages in the league. Absolute, the number one for the Rangers, who are close to number one in the league. And it's not for nothing, because of he is in the goal. Selke, best defensive forward. Some say this is the trophy of the names that were on this list the year before. That's why I thought I'd pick at least two other guys. Well, Selke, you always have to mention Patrice Bergeron, Boston Bruins, although it's not his best season. Alexander Barkov, Florida Panthers, always on this list. Honorable mention for Mark Stone, who didn't play enough games, I think, up till this point to qualify. But in case he would play all the games, he would definitely be on the list. He's so good. And I picked two finalists who are definitely underrated. One is Ryan Hartman of the Minnesota Wild, who is right now second in plus-minus in the league. And as number one, I picked the plus-minus leader. You don't know who it is. No, you don't. Put your hands down. Plus-minus leader is... Elias Lindholm of the Calgary Flames. Great defensive play. He is offensively gifted. Playing with Johnny Gaudreau is, I think, a good point, but he is the defensive brain behind Johnny Gaudreau and his success. Would definitely be worth considerations for the Selke. And finally, the hardest pick, the Norris. Not only four candidates, I mean, the usual four, Adam Fox, Victor Hedman, Cale Makar, Roman Josi, these four are the best defenders and the best D-men in the league. Maybe Quinn Hughes could join this list soon. We will see. Will depend a lot on what else happens in Vancouver. And of course, as every year, the best defensive defenseman, Jacob Slavin from the Carolina Hurricanes. He could also be a Norris winner. Some more points may be good, but yeah, the Langway Award would be his. He's the best. I think the Norris Trophy this year will be won by Adam Fox, one more reason to wear Rangers. He is level with Victor Hedman in points on the day of recording. He's doing a fantastic job, and he's defensively, I think, a little better than Cale Makar, who has about this almost the same offensive numbers. But as mentioned, it could be a draw between Josi, Hedman, Makar, and Fox. Okay, that's it for this one. Thank you very much for watching. Don't forget to hit like and subscribe. And let me know in the comment section below, who do you think, up to this point, is winner of which trophy? Would be interested to know your opinion. I will make another video like that when the regular season is over, as mentioned, and compare what I've said now to what I'll say then. Thanks again for watching. Have a good time. See you soon. Goodbye.